In this module, I'm very excited to be embarking on a whole new application journey with you that is around the magic wand. Now, let me take this opportunity to talk about the kind of sensors that we will be using and what are the prospects, you know, as we expand to the landscape of sensors, as we specifically look at, you know, TinyML applications. Now, generally, when you talk about machine learning as it's applied to sensors, it often ends up being focused on two domains. It happens to be speech and happens to be vision. And we've covered that in the last two applications. However, when you are talking about embedded sensors, there's a large number of sensors out there for being able to measure temperature, to pressure, to humidity, and being able to tell the strength of a magnetic field and so forth. There are many different kinds of sensors out there. So if we can tap into some of these rich array of sensors, then we may be able to uncover a whole new range of applications that are specifically unique to TinyML itself, and not just the usual machine learning applications for just speech and vision. Now, we will specifically be talking about the inertial measurement unit, also known as the IMU. And this is a useful measurement unit for measuring movement in 3D space. The inertial measurement unit is a really rich sensor that measures displacement and rotation in 3D spaces, right? So that's movement in X, Y, Z, and then rotational, the angular movement also. And it generates a lot of data in a very short amount of time and gives you a very rich amount of information that's useful for tracking movement. And you need to know how to deal with this data that's coming through it. Specifically, a 9 degree of freedom IMU has 3 sensors in it. It's got an accelerometer, it's got a gyroscope, and it's got a magnetometer. And you can really do very interesting things by collecting data that's coming from these sensors and fusing them together. For example, the accelerometer has the ability to tell us about displacements in the X, Y, and Z axis. And the 3 axis of the gyroscopes has the ability to give us rotational data about a known point. But the general point I'm trying to get across here is that, you know, these are very small, tiny sensors, have a lot of ability, and they consume very low power, and they still can enable very rich application experiences. Moreover, you want to think about the size of the device because you want these to be really small so you can put them anywhere, and you want them to be lightweight, especially for robotic applications. And you want them to also be really cheap, so you can use a lot of them and do very interesting TinyML applications with them. Because of their low cost and because of the low power consumption, you know, there are countless applications with IMUs. For example, you can do embedded sensing on bodies for activities like sports, looking at the swing as you're playing baseball or golf, or activity recognition for everyday activities. And seeing how mobile an elderly person is and whether they're getting up on time and so on, or detecting medical ailments before they actually become problematic. So you can enable a rich number of robotic applications. Specifically, IMUs are very useful for things like stabilization in drones. And of course, IMUs are already there that are used in like things like smartwatches, like the Apple Watch, for instance, that actually detects, you know, a person suddenly falling down. And it can and then alert the medical emergency health worker. So all that sounds exciting, but what are some of the challenges? Well, there are some gotchas with IMUs, and they're largely about interpretability, sensor drift, and the deployment sensitivity. Interpretability is a notion that when you look at the sensor data, can you really make sense of it? For example, we can see images and we can hear audio that we are actually playing. But when you look at some of the sensor data that's coming from an IMU, we don't really have an easy way to interpret this kind of data because it's both spatial and temporal at the same time. And that makes it challenging to be able to easily build applications. So that's the first thing. The second thing is that the sensors are not quite ideal. In other words, the sensors tend to behave differently over time. Now, an ideal sensor would be one that has the exact same behavior on day one as on day 1000, for instance. And well, it turns out that many of these small sensors tend to have problems like drift, for example. Gyroscopes are specifically subject to these bias instabilities. And that means that over time, their initial zero reference tends to drift with some kind of unknown offset. And that can be problematic if you have some sort of assumptions about, you know, how you engineer the application on the first day versus, you know, when it's deployed in the field after a long time. But, you know, 1,000 days after, for example, the sensor has a certain drift, and that means that you've got to suddenly compensate for that. But how do you do that if you've already deployed it in the field? Now, accelerometers, you know, available commercially, they're sensitive to vibration. And that, you know, any kind of non-gravity accelerations can also affect them. So you want to be able to understand some of these issues with sensor non-idealities in order to be able to use them effectively in applications over time. Last one is really about the deployment sensitivity. You often have to calibrate or fine-tune some of these sensors on an individual basis, because these tend to have minor differences in fabrication and in initial measurements that you get out of them could vary from sensor to sensor. And they can have a major effect on the application outcome, you know, some of which we'll actually see as we build the magic wand application. So these differences end up, you know, manifesting in terms of biases in the data that you have to compensate for, you know, in the pre-processing stage. And we'll look at that in our application. With all that said, the thing I'm trying to get you excited about is the fact that there are countless applications that can use one or more of these sensors for purposes that are well beyond the scope of what we are covering here. We will specifically focus on the magic wand application that uses the accelerometer and the gyroscope inside the IMU. But keep in mind, that's just the tip of the iceberg. And I'm looking forward to seeing you do some really exciting projects that you will build after you're done with this course. Well, with that said, let's get started with the magic wand application.